In this session, we're going to talk about, before we actually get into playing on game day, I need to lay the groundwork or the foundation of what is our single mental game goal for the day. So you have to specify what your goal is if you want to accomplish it. You need to focus on it. People go, well, you know, what are you supposed to think of when you hit a bad shot or when you get distracted or whatever? This is it. This is all coming together right here in this part. It's the mental game goal for game day. And here it is. This sentence can change your life if you will listen and carefully apply this. Here's the goal. My goal on game day from the mental game point is put my mind in position to score. Put my mind in position to score. When you hit a shot, you've got the mechanics, you've got course management, you've got physics, you know, or excuse me, physiology, am I in it fit enough for good shape? You've got clubs, but you also have the mental side. And so there's a lot of things that affect the shot, but let me tell you this, if your mind is off and there's some fear in there or trepidation or you're thinking of the wrong thing, your swing's going to look bad, the mechanics are. You're not going to look right. You're going to pull the wrong club, or the club you have isn't going to work right, and you won't know what the issue was. You have to be a great self-corrector in tournament golf to be good across the long haul. And so here's what we want to do. We want to make sure first that our mind is right, we're thinking correctly, so our body has a chance to do exactly what it's been trained to do. Once we do that, we're not robots, but once we think well, we've eliminated the mental issue as the problem with the golf shot, and then we can clearly see, did I pull the wrong club, or did I make a swing error, or did I miscalculate the wind somehow, or do I just not have a club in my bag that works for that? So here we go. The goal. Put your mind in position to score. What does that mean? I'm going to make it very simple for you. The brain works just like this. The muscles are going to hit the shot, and your brain's going to send information to your muscles, and that information is going to be used to hit the golf shot. Your muscles don't have brains, and your brain doesn't have muscles. There's got to be a connection there. You must send the right information. When I used to play with my mentor, Johnny, I remember playing with him when I was young. I was about 14. We're playing along. Johnny's on his way to shooting a 61 on this particular day. I saw him do that twice as a kid. We're on number 17. He pulls out an 8-iron, hits it up there. It's about 168 par 3, knocks it up there to about 2 feet. As he puts his club in his bag, he says, Picasso. I've had about enough of that. So I said, Johnny, what do you mean Picasso? What do you mean Picasso? You say that every time you hit a great shot. You said that at least 17 times a day. And he said, come here, Cookie. So I walked up on the tee box with him. Of course, I'm hitting second because he's playing out of his mind. Puts his arm around and says, what do you see? Look out there. Tell me what you see. You know, I saw a lake to the right. I saw, you know, short side to the left. I saw the flag in the back, you know, and pin placement's not so good. The green's kind of sloping away. So I described, there's the flag, there's this, there's the water, there's the short side. He goes, no. What do you see? I said, well, okay, there's a short side, there's the flag, there's the water. He goes, son, you don't understand. I said, well, I guess not. I'm asking a question. What do you mean? What do you see? He said, son, listen, every time you have a golf shot, you have a choice. He said, and you've got a blank canvas in front of you. Son, you got to become an artist. You look out there and you begin to paint on that canvas exactly what you want to have happen. I want to know your target. I want to know the shape of the ball coming in. I want to know the trajectory. So he began to teach me visualization without ever using that word, and I don't use that word. But it's the understanding of how the ball is going to go to where I want it to go. So he said, listen, you've got a blank canvas and you've got to paint that picture. And then he said this, son, I just choose to paint a masterpiece. And when I hit it and I return my club to the bag, I simply say, Picasso. I signed the painting. What a lesson for me as a young man. He wasn't talking about angles and vectors and, you know, kick points in the shaft and all of that stuff that sometimes we, you know, we get overwhelmed and enamored with. He was simply saying, you've got to play the game out in front of you. And he taught me this idea of visualization without ever using the word. And so the idea is this, and he said this. He said, listen, son, you got that blank canvas. He said, if you don't choose to paint a masterpiece, I just choose to paint a masterpiece. And that's why I signed it, Picasso. But if you don't choose to paint a masterpiece, you're going to spend your life on the golf course with a lot of stick figure outcomes. That stuck with me for a lifetime. And I understand the first element then, the brain as it sends to the muscles are asking for pictures. They like pictures more than they like words. That picture must be a good picture. It must be a picture of what you want to have happen, not what you don't want to have happen. We've talked about all the elements. Those elements are guides, water, bunkers, out of bounds. All of those things are guides showing you where point B is. And point B should be in a quality position that gives me the best shot at a birdie. And so as I go into this, I teach players, I'm teaching you right now, here's what I want you to do. I want you to call your shot. See it is the first word. See it. As you say, see it. Target. Where do you want the ball to end up? Shape. How do you want it to get there? Trajectory. How do you want it to go in the air? Those are the three elements that you use to create the picture and the masterpiece. See it is the first word. It's the first information the muscles need. It starts the reaction that we're going to speak about in another session. See it. Call your shot. Paint a masterpiece. That is the first trigger in succeeding in this definition. Put your mind in position to succeed.